Hey, I'm Karina. Welcome to my channel. I'm a makeup artist. I love to create makeup looks that are more on the natural and classy and wearable side of things. So if that sounds like something you would like too, then I would love it if you would subscribe. Today I'm gonna show you a few different looks you can do when you're wearing a beige shirt or a beige dress or beige anything. I find that with beige, oftentimes when I put it on, I'll feel a lot more washed out than when I put on even white or black or anything like that, just because it is more of like the skin tone color. So I want to show you makeup looks that you can wear that are still really elegant and classy looking. You can wear them in the day or in the evening, but they'll just kind of make you feel a little bit more alive and just give you a few more looks that you can kind of add into your repertoire. And I find that these looks are just beautiful with beige. This is another one of my videos that's going to be a part of my Makeup for Your Outfit series. So check out the last one I did. I'll link it up here. And that one is for a white t-shirt. For today's video, I did my base, I did my foundation, concealer, blush, and all that stuff. I picked up the Laura Mercier Tinted Moisturizer. It's an oil-free tinted moisturizer from Sephora. I've heard really good things about it, so I went and grabbed it, and this is probably the third time that I've worn it, and I have to say I absolutely love it. So I'm going to be including this in a couple more of my future videos, so stay tuned. I just had my eyebrows microbladed. I just had them touched up actually. So they're still healing. So if you see weird flaky things, don't judge me. And they also are a lot darker right now than they actually heal down to. So just a little FYI. So for my first look, it's gonna be really simple, really easy to do. And I think that the simplicity of it actually just makes the look very elegant and pretty looking, because you're not over trying, you're not wearing too many bold colors. I always like to do an eye focus or a lip focus, so it's really rare that I would do like a lot on my eyes and on my lips, just because that's not my style and I always feel way overdone when I try to do that. So this is gonna be one of the eye focus looks, and I have a palette by Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Vintage Vamp. And it's a really pretty palette, obviously has some like burgundy berry tones in it, and it's really expensive. Obviously you don't have to use Charlotte Tilbury, you can just use any like berry toned or burgundy color that you have. And I don't know why, but when I wear beige, I like to go to like berries and burgundies. And since we'll be coming into fall shortly, I thought this would be kind of really appropriate. I think it's because beige can wash you out, like I said, and when I'm thinking about adding a little bit of color into the eyes, burgundy tone just looks nice on everyone. It's season appropriate, and it's really easy to just kind of use as a little bit more color to your look without feeling like overdone or tacky or anything like that. So all I'm gonna do for this look is take a fluffy brush. So this is the MAC 217, and I'm just gonna dip it right into that color, swirl it around, tap it off a little bit, and pretty much I just want to use this as a wash of color all over my eyelid. So I'm starting right on my eyelid, right in the center, and I'm just going to focus most of the color on the actual lid itself, and then as the eyeshadow gets off the brush, then I'll start to blend it up and out a little bit. I'm just keeping it really soft, like it's just a gentle wash of color over my eyelid and my eye. When you're working with one color like this, just step back and kind of tilt your head up and just make sure that the edges are all really even and that there's the same amount of pigment on this eye as there is on this eye. Sometimes that can get a little bit tricky when you haven't laid down a transition shade already. Then this color, whatever's on the brush, will really kind of like catch onto your skin. So really kind of paying attention to that small detail of how much pigment has kind of been displaced and where is key to just doing this look. Then I'm just gonna take my MAC 239, it's that flat kind of shader brush, and I'm gonna dip it into the exact same color, Enhance, and then I'm gonna wrap that color around the bottom of my eye as well. I'm kind of blowing out the outer corner of my eye a little bit more, and then I am gonna bring it pretty much all the way in to the very inner corner, but keeping it really tight along the lash line as I come in. So it's super simple. We are just gonna use this one shade, which makes it so doable for anyone. I am gonna do a little bit of a liner just in my waterline, and I'm using Costa Riche by MAC. I love, love, love this pencil. It's just a beautiful brown with like a hint of kind of orange or warmness in it. So if you have any color eyes, it really just pops them, like blue and green eyes especially. It really just brings the color out. So we're just gonna tight line the top and the bottom lid, both sides. So I just curled my lashes and threw on some mascara, and that's all I'm gonna do for eyes. I am gonna put a lip on. This one is Barbara by NARS, and the liner I'm using is Subculture by MAC. So I'm just keeping the lip pretty nude because I have obviously the pop of color on my eyes. So that's my first look done. You can't feel washed out when you have a bit of a pop of color on your eyes. I think this cranberry shade is simple and pretty. For my second look, I'm gonna do a lip focus. I took off the cranberry eyeshadow and I just left my mascara on. For this look, I probably would just wear mascara or maybe like a very light wash of a bronzer or something on my eyelid. I wanna do like a deep burgundy, kind of purpley lip. But what I'm gonna do for you today is Vampira by Kat Von D. It's one of her liquid lipsticks. Every time I wear this lip, I've got this one and a really dark purple one that I really love. And every time I wear them, because they're so bold, I get so many compliments on them and I just feel good wearing it. So sometimes it's fun to be really bold. And I still think it looks nice and classy when you have like the right outfit on. Like I'm still wearing a really nice beige silk kind of top. So it's all kind of about pairing, you know, when you're wearing the right outfit with the right eye look, you can do this bold lip and it can just be a really nice look. So definitely don't be afraid to go bold sometimes, but just kind of tone down everything else if you do want to do one feature. So with the liquid lipsticks, I do like to start with a liner. I'm gonna use the liner Burgundy by MAC. Once I'm happy with that outer shape that I like, then it's easier to take the wand. Then you can really just kind of go right up to the line that you already drew and then blend inside the lip. If you're wearing any kind of a bold lip, especially a liquid lip, make sure you actually open your mouth and get right into those corners. Otherwise, there's just a weird blank space there and it doesn't look very nice. When you're gonna do a bold lip, then you actually have to put a little bit more effort in and make sure it's like nice and crisp and evenly covered. So this is my second look. It works really well with beige because, again, you can't look washed out when you have this bold of a color going on. You don't have to do purple or burgundy. You can do any kind of bold lip you want. And when you keep the eyes toned down, the shirt toned down, and your lips pop, it just looks really nice. For my third and final look, I'm gonna do a simple brown smoky eye. And you can use whatever brown eyeshadow you have. For this look, I'm just gonna start with a skin toned eyeshadow. So whatever color of skin you are, just choose a shade that matches your own skin tone. So I'm gonna be using the Stila In The Know palette, and I'm gonna use this shade here called Desert. I'm just gonna take a fluffy brush again. So this is the Morphe M433. And then I'm just going to put that right up onto my brow bone and right into the crease. And this is just kind of laying down some groundwork so that when I go in with that brown shadow, it'll just really easily blend into this color that we're laying down. Next, same brush, I'm gonna go in with this brown called Driftwood. And with that, I'm just gonna put it all over my lid and right up into that shade that we just laid down. And then I'm gonna take my flat shader brush and I'm just gonna go run that underneath my eye along my lower lash line. I don't want to smoke it out too much, so I'm keeping it pretty close in. Just do whatever looks good on you or what you're comfortable with. And then I'm going to take this Eye Kohl by MAC. It's called Teddy. It's just a brown pencil, but it has a slight shimmer to it. You can use just a flat brown. You can use whatever brown pencil you have. We're just going to go in and add a little bit more definition around the lashes. So I'm just going to draw that right along my lash band, and I'll make it a little bit thicker than I normally would, because I'm gonna blend it out with my shader brush. You don't have to make it perfect. And then take your shader brush and then just start to kind of blend that up and out just so that the edge isn't as wobbly and wonky. And then I'm also gonna take Teddy and run it along the lower lashes, and I'll keep that pretty tight right into my lower lashes. Right away before I do the other side, I'll just blend that out with that flat shader brush as well. I'm gonna line my waterline with that same Eye Kohl as well. And then I am just gonna do a nude lip. This one is Honey by Morphe. So that's my last look. It's still all quite neutral, but because we went a little bit deeper or heavier on the eyes, then it still makes your features pop, well, your eyes pop. And it looks really nice with this beige toned shirt, just because the browns and the browns look nice together, but I don't feel washed out. Thank you so much for watching. Comment below and let me know which look you like the best, the cranberry eye, the darker bold lip, or the brown smoky eye. All are simple, cute, wearable looks, and if you're into that kind of makeup like I am, then consider subscribing to my channel and let me know if you like the idea of the outfit series videos, like pairing your makeup with your outfits. I really hope it's helpful for you. It's kind of like my favorite thing to do, just look at an outfit and think about what kind of makeup look I want to go with that, depending on what I'm wearing and kind of the occasion that I'm going to. Yeah, and let me know if you like my new background as well. I'm gonna paint a couple pictures and put them up as well, so it's not quite done. So it's a bit of a work in progress, but so far it looks pretty cute. All right, I'll see you in my next video.
No, I'ma put it down like that. I'm leaving, I ain't coming back. You don't like the way I act anyway.